And I think we'll now start with our first panel. We have three speakers. The first speaker will be Georgi Shavashidze. He was the Deputy Minister of Education here in Georgia. And then it will be followed by Mohamed Isakhangi, if I pronounce that right, I hope. And the title of that is Higher Education in Azerbaijan Between Heritage and Modern Thought. And then the third speaker, Angelina Hovhannisyan, will be talking about reforms in higher education in Armenia in the context of the Bologna process. So you can all come up here and talk at the podium, or if you wish, you can sit here and talk. But we'll start with Georgi Shavashidze. Thank you.
Thank you, Steph. Thank you very much, and welcome, everybody. I would like to start my presentation this morning with a couple of points. I'll try to give you a general picture of education in Georgia and trends and challenges, of course, we're facing. It was quite a task to come up with a presentation on 20 minutes to list all challenges that the Georgian education system is facing. And I would probably start with a description of major challenges in our education system. What is going right now in Georgia, that of course the first thing that comes to my mind is the quality of education, as probably in all countries over the globe. But especially in Georgia, what we're having here, it's a very different landscape in quality-wise. As Takuna mentioned previously, it's not only quality but also equity, accessibility for all students to a quality education in our country. And what is important to mention that over the last decade or so, Georgia took quite impressive steps in order to improve educational landscape and system. And I would mention first and utmost combating corruption in education, and that was our major challenge that we had for years. Right now we're trying to work out quality mechanisms following the Bologna principles, following recent Yerevan communique, which was kind of 10 days or 2 weeks ago in Yerevan, of the ministerial gathering of all Bologna countries, and also try to synchronize our efforts with higher education, European higher education area. What we're doing in this respect, that we're closely cooperating with European agencies in order to internationalize the enhancement, quality enhancement system in Georgia, to introduce first time ever international scrutiny, to invite outside experts in order to conduct accreditation, and not only accreditation, but also institutional and program accreditation in Georgia. Government already declared a strategic plan of development of education, and that's a long-term commitment, a 10-year plan that we'd like to achieve a very rigorous accreditation standards in this country. Starting from this academic year, we'll introduce a new standard in higher education, and all universities are invited on a voluntary basis to be a part of a pilot project. This pilot project means that all of them will be provided with assistance in order to come up with self-evaluation, with all necessary mechanisms that are in place, and state will provide them with funding at first, and that would be a kind of trial period. We'll have a quite impressive pool of foreign experts. As you know, Georgia is a small country. In all small countries, the major challenge is to find a really non-biased opinion, because in some disciplines we're having a very clustered society. So five professors who evaluate each other, and everybody is like members of families, so it's very difficult to really judge quality. And what is happening right now in Georgia is we're having two things in parallel. One is so-called authorization, and that's kind of introduced, actually. It's a mixture of institutional accreditation with features of licensing. What we'd like to have is a clear-cut institutional and program accreditation through the grantors. We'll have, as stated, 7 years accreditation period instead of 5 years here, because what we would like to really assess what is a linkage between the higher education and the labor market, what is employability, etc. It was never done before, no tracer studies were made, and that's exactly the point that we're making right now. In connection with the labor market, we already started a very interesting program, and it's a study of labor market itself, first time ever. It was never done in Georgia. Many times I would say that the first time ever, but excuse me for that, we're trying to be as innovative as we can. And a major headache for years in Georgia remains the same, and that's a very weak integration of research and teaching. In this respect, likewise as in other post-socialist countries or Soviet countries, we had quite a system of science which was really, really difficult to handle. We had Academy of Sciences with research institutions under the Academy of Sciences. We had so-called university science, the weakest probably science in the former Soviet Union, and strongest one, military science. Now what we're trying to do, in 2010, decision was made to unify scientific research institutions with universities, and it was done. To the best of my understanding, it was done in a very, you know, not really convincing manner, I would say. And what we're trying to do right now is to establish a place for science within academia, and that's an important innovation for education system in Georgia. Starting from January this year, we have 42 research institutions now in three major Georgian universities: the Ilya State University, Tbilisi State University, and Medical University of Tbilisi, and Technical University, four. And 42 research institutions. Now we'll try to come up with a new package of legislative changes, and starting from the fall, we'll have a new legislation in this respect, which provides us with the opportunity to have research professorship, to have graduate schools in Georgia, and that was never the case before, to have postdocs, and those are a new notion that coming to our educational reality. Also, what we're trying to achieve is to create understandable system of measurement of scientific of science and research aimed on scientific outcome, with special attention on commercialization of science. What we do so far, we established under the Prime Minister of Georgia, first time ever, was established a Council on Research and Innovations. And Prime Minister is leading this council. All line ministers are presented, and also businesses there. So we have business and industry talking with government officials and university sector on matters of research and development. So as a first outcome of this decision, we identified a couple of areas that are of high importance for the state. And those areas are STEM, or better to say STEAM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics, and agriculture, that will pay special attention to. In order to boost a little bit STEAM education in Georgia, we did two things in parallel. First, that was quite a big project. It's a Millennium Challenge Corporation and Georgian government signed an agreement on grant. It's a $140 million grant, and this grant will be distributed in three directions. First one is vocational education, second one is secondary education, and the intention is to retrain all STEM teachers in Georgia, and also to provide special assistance to women in STEM. I think that Joanna is hearing this, that we're really trying to motivate and create packages and set of packages for women to participate in STEM. And also in higher education, so far we created a consortium of universities, three Georgian major universities, Ilia State University, Tbilisi State University, and Georgian Technical University, created a consortium with San Diego University. And here, starting from this September, we'll have a first intake of students. Our aim is to have 500 students a year per annum, and we'll have a BA status in four disciplines. We'll start with four, but we'll continue with six, and then on later stage with eight disciplines in STEM directions. And the intention here is, the condition was that all programs should be EBIT accredited, and by the end of the day, graduates will receive two diplomas, Georgian Diploma of Post University and San Diego State University Diploma. That's a quite interesting project, and this project is open to the region. We are not intending to close up this project only to the needs of Georgia, and we're inviting international students to participate. And first, of course, our neighboring countries are encouraged to become a part of this big project. What's the landscape right now in Georgia in international education, that we're having quite a number of international students already. Up to 5% of all Georgian students are from different countries. And this is a very, impressive trend, and we're growing trend. But also what we're trying to achieve is not only to have a BA level STEM education established in Georgia, but also have a second and third levels of education also to be provided to our students and graduates of future graduates of San Diego Georgian University's project. So we solicited some funding from private sources. And again, it's the first time ever in Georgia that we're having quite an impressive private-public partnership, for example. And we're creating a graduate school in STEM direction with MA and PhD degrees. And one of leading American universities will be providing this education here. We're establishing branch campus in Tbilisi, Georgia. Again, open to the region. Right now we're in the process of selecting finalists. We had 12 bees from different universities. We had a meeting with quite a number of universities in the US recently. We started with 39 universities, then we downsized to 12. Now we're having three lucky winners, and out of them one would be the finalists, and then we'll have a backup universities, plan B in a way. What is also interesting that it's not only a second and third level of education, MA and PhD, but also we're intending to have quite impressive, I would say, cutting edge research labs in this university. So what we're looking at in this grad school to be a real hub or center of scientific and research excellence in Georgia, and to set up a rigorous research agenda in order to attract PhD students and master students, because, and again, that's a challenge in Georgia, probably challenge number one, we're having over aging scientists and researchers, we're having a gap between the different generations, and generational gap is an issue, and also PhD students and quality doctoral students and doctoral research is remained to be very low. Probably Simon will continue later on with this exercise and explain us what is reality in PhD programs. What we're trying to do from state perspective is to provide PhD doctoral students with possible support that we can provide. For second year already in Georgia, we're having close to 300 doctoral students receiving state grants. And Rustavelli Science Foundation is issuing those grants. For country like Georgia, it's quite a sizable grant. It's up to $21,000 per annum. And doctorants are encouraged to participate in this competition. So far, this program works well. I think it's a way out, I believe. science was talking about research and scientific outcome before trying to put it all in one picture, what we did, what did the study supported by USAID, and that was again first time ever it was a snapshot analysis of research outcomes in Georgia. It was not really a science audit, full scale science audit, but very impressive findings were presented. And Professor Bergwazi is sitting here, she is one of the authors of this wonderful exercise. And based on the outcomes of this research, what we learned so far that in some instances, in some cases, Georgian science is still in a good position. I'm underlining still, and it's not it's because of traditionally strong schools in physics, astronomy, mathematics, partially in life sciences. In some cases and instances were really leading according to the quality of publications, not only to compare with former Soviet Union countries, but also Eastern European and Central European countries. But again, in some areas traditionally, as social sciences and humanities were nowhere. So that's a way to work on, and that's exactly what we're looking at very carefully. And one of the intentions is to create a graduate schools in Georgia, as I already mentioned, we'll start with STEM education. Also, we're having another support line for agricultural education. In agriculture's work, we're building a really excellent facility in Georgia with 8 new disciplines together with our American partners again, and that's in Georgian Technical University. We'll have a new faculty of agricultures. We'll inaugurate this place in October, I believe, and it will be equipped with a cutting-edge laboratory with quite impressive and solid professors, of course, that's important. And we're working with Iowa State University on content, on curriculum, on content of this new discipline, which was never the case in Georgia. On innovation line, we're working with newly created Georgian Agency for Technologies under the Ministry of Economy, and that's what tried to cover universities and vocational schools in Georgia with innovation labs, with fab labs, etc., in order to boost attention of youngsters and kids. One of fab labs is at Ilya State University. I think that you will have an opportunity to have a look at that. It's really working 24/7. It's a very tiny little place, but very popular now in Georgia. We're having quite a number of now we're starting with technical university, we'll have the same like facilities in Kovi, in Tel Aviv, Zudit, in Kutaisi, quite a number of vocational schools, and it's also a big project that would create interest for innovations among our students. Also, we're working on quite a number of other directions. Again, challenges in higher education, say like 3 minutes, I know. Okay, thank you for keeping me elected. We're trying to create new modular programs for vocational schools, and we're doing this. Starting with this academic year, we'll have modular studies in vocational schools, and also what we're trying to do is to link professional initial TVET education with higher education. Till now, we had a dead end when students of vocational school could continue their studies in higher institutes of higher learning or transfer their credits they earned at WET stage. Now we're eliminating these barriers, and quite a number of universities are also having the initial training, initial vocational courses. And those courses will be also introduced at schooling level, at secondary school level. That's extremely important that we will have a connection between this tool. As I already mentioned, we'll have a new law on education, and most importantly, we're not talking about challenges. Every time we're saying that, you know, the quality of students is, you know, decreasing in these countries, and I know that in reality, what is happening in secondary school level, that will also introduce changes. We'll have new schools of education. One of the first one, I believe, will be hosted by Ilya State University, will be part of Ilya State University. We'll have four categories of teachers. We increase salary of teachers. We will continue doing this in order to have the salaries of teachers compatible to average salary in budgetary sector in Georgia. In reality, that means increase of salary three times per year, 2017. And what we'll try to do to attract as much talent to schools as possible. So that's another way. We already increased the salaries of researchers in 42 research universities out of different universities, and the increase was quite impressive. In January, we increased salaries on 300% in average. So it was done, but now we're continuing with facilities, with laboratories and equipment. But where do we get in a way that we're creating a different sphere for different directions in science? We started with Institute of Physics this year and Institute of Applied Mathematics, and we're creating a great system in Institute of Mathematics because we're part of big international projects. We're working with CERN, and quite a number of Georgian scientists will have the opportunity here in Georgia to work on data produced in CERN and process data produced in CERN. Also, we're working with KK, it's a Japanese atomic agency, and we're having doctorants in both locations, also in Dubna. Right now, 35 Georgian scientists, physicists, and engineers are working on CERN. More than 150 scientists are working in different research facilities overseas. We created an institution and hub for them in Georgia. And it's already starting at the Institute of Quantum Physics in Georgian Technical University, which becomes Georgian Technological University very soon. And that's the way how we're trying to attract our brains back to Georgia and to create a connection. Okay, well, now we'll shut up, I promise. I know what I'm pressing, and thank you for attention.
Yeah, thank you very much. That was a very comprehensive review of reforms that Georgia is trying to introduce in the last 2 years. I think, you know, very often when scholars like myself come here and we listen to taxi drivers, we think nothing works in higher education in Georgia. You know, we have taxi drivers with 2 degrees in physics and sociology, and they're driving taxis, and they tell us that, you know, it's no good. Nothing's changing, but I think what Gio tells us is that real efforts are being made. I'm particularly interested in hearing about the training for teachers here at Ilya State and at other universities. I think it's what you stressed here is the connection between high schools and before high schools, elementary education, which obviously feed into higher education. And we have to think about how those levels of education are integrated and reformed as well. And I guess you cover all of those. So thanks very much. It was really very interesting and informative.